You know, I have a... Hello and welcome. The beginning of this show is always a pain because I start the damn show and then I can't find it. You know. God damn it. So you know, professional showmanship, that's all. That works great, you know. The first thing you see, if you're watching from the beginning, is me fumbling around like an old man trying to figure out how to work the VCR, you know. Which basically is what it is. I'm an old man trying to figure out how to work this computer. I mean, for Christ's sake, you know. I go live, okay, so where is it? You know, and I do all the stuff. Live, yes. John Troy, yes. Search, not there. You know, and I keep fumbling around. Ugh. And then, after that, you get to hear the old man complain about it. Isn't that a great show? Uh-huh. Well, yeah, that's what you get for the price of admission. That's what you get. Now let's play a song. The other night, dear, as I lay sleeping, I dreamed I held you in my arms. But when I woke, dear, I was mistaken, and I hung my head and cried. I'll always love you and make you happy if you would only say the same. But if you leave me and love another, you'll regret it all someday. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. Told me once, dear, you really love me. No one could come between. But now you've left me to love another. You have shattered all my dreams. In all my dreams, dear, you seem to leave me. When I awake, my poor heart breaks. So won't you come back and make me happy? I'll forgive, dear, I'll take all the blame. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. Hey, Janet Norton. Janet Norton Depew. You know, Janet Norton Depew. Janet Norton's her maiden name. And Depew is her married name, I assume. But whenever I hear your name in my head, Janet Norton Depew, it's a good name. It's a good solid name. Janet Norton Depew. It has a nice cadence. Janet Norton Depew. But when I hear it in my head, it goes, Janet Norton Depew! That's colorful, right? It's like a rainbow. So, Janet Norton Depew! If you stick around, you'll hear your song. Someday the thrill is gone, it's gone away from me. Oh, the thrill is gone, gone away from me. Though I still live on, so lonely I'll be. The thrill is gone, gone away for good. Oh, the thrill is gone, it's gone away for good. Someday I know I'll be over it, baby, like I know a man should. From your spell, I'm free. I am free from your spell, and now that it's over, all I can do is wish you well. I came up with the idea. I will say that it was my idea. The idea that I came up with was mine, but it kind of takes away from it when you find out later that everybody else has already thought of it. But at least I thought of it myself. And what I thought of, I was saying, I want to write a song. So I was trying to think of something, and I came up with this idea of an angel. Like this girl that I love, the object of my desire, was an angel. And she has wings, see? And she spreads her wings. And she wraps her wings around me. Get it? Now, it could be wholesome. Or it could be double entendre. That's French. And so I thought I was very clever. I thought I was very clever to come up with it. Hey, wow, see? Because they could be her arms. I was explaining it to my roommate. And then I put on Live at the Regal and listened to B.B. King. I got a sweet little angel. I love the way she spread her wings.
I would go, huh?
Whoa, sweet little angel, I love the way she spread her wings. When she spread her wings around me, I get joy and everything.
Well, hey, how do you think of that? Duh.
Well, you know, that's when you start getting out of your teens. That's when you begin to realize you don't know everything. But there's that really lovely period with teenagers from about the age of like 15 to 20. Where they know everything. They don't know anything, but they think they know everything. Yeah, that's... That's fun. Those guys. I was one of them. I thought I knew it all. So thank you, BB, for setting me straight. And then, fast forward 10 years, and I was playing with him. Playing with him. Not with him in the same band, but we were in the same bill. Got a picture. He put his arm around me. Nice guy. About the same height as me. The picture is John Hall, Bonnie Raitt, B.B. King, and me. In a parking lot. Outdoor show. Someplace. Back east. He was a nice guy. Sweet guy. Like you'd expect. He was the way he seemed. I had an encounter with a rooster. I'm not very farmy. I'm more of a city person. Grew up in a small town, Oceanside, but it was small then. But I was never around animals much, except for, you know, dogs here and there. And I happened to be on a property where there were animals, farm animals, and I walked by a chicken coop, and I guess I walked too closely, and they could come and go in the coop. Well, or was this guy outside? Maybe he got outside somehow. There was a coop inside this fenced off area, and he was outside the fence, this rooster. Thank you, anime. And he attacked. He just charged me. He just started. I looked and looked again because here he come. And I watched him come because there's a rooster. I was like, what do you got in mind? And ow! He started pecking the shit out of my ankles. Get! You know. So I was starting to do a little dance there. You know, what the hell? You know. And I was kicking him away, and he kept coming back. What's your problem, man? And I got angry. And so I punted. I kicked. Yes, some animals were harmed. Well, apparently not, because I put him up for 3 points. I kicked him. It was a good follow through. Caught him right across the middle of the body, right perfectly on the instep, and away he went. I pew, you know. So I sent him like there. And you asked for it, didn't you? And I watched him. He went down, hit the ground running, came straight back at me. Unbelievable. And I ran for it, because I saw that he wasn't going to... I would have to kill him. I would have to kill him to stop him. Nothing was going to stop him. Either run away or kill him. So I ran away. The rooster chased me off. I went, oh, well, that's why they're... The names of sports teams and stuff. That's why people think they're so tough. They are. They have no fear. No fear. No fear. I was very impressed with that little guy.
No one told me. She lied. No one told me about her. How many people cry? Too late to say you're sorry. How no one
why should I care? Please don't bother trying to find her, she's not there. Tell you about the way she looks, the way she acts, color of her hair, her voice was soft and cool, her eyes were clear and bright. She's not there. No one told me about her. What could I do? No one told me about her, though they all knew. It's too late to say you're sorry. How would I know? Why should I care? Please don't bother trying to find her, she's not there. Tell you about the way she looked, the way she act, the color of her hair, her voice was soft and cool, her eyes were clear and bright. She's not there. It's too late to say you're sorry. How would I know? Why should I care? Don't bother trying to find her, she's not there. Let me tell you about the way she looked, the way she act, the color of her hair, her voice soft and cool, her eyes are clear and bright, but she's not there. Let me tell you about the way she looked, the way she acted, the color of her hair. Her voice was soft and cool, her eyes were clear and bright, but she's not there. Yes, that's a great aeong. Keep trying. Great thong. You better stop while you're ahead. Sklarz, I don't know Sklarz. He's making that up. Where were you really, Tom? Sklarz, likely story. Nothing is more refreshing on a hot day than a frozen video. Boy, I had, you know what, I turned off, I have AC here, but when you turn it on, it sounds sort of like, so I turned it off, so, basically, I turned off my AC for you. You. And, so now I'm sitting here cooking. When I last looked, it was 102 degrees. 102 here in Laguna Hills. It's hot. I saw a dog chasing a rabbit. They're both walking. It's hot. I can settle now and be doing just fine till I hear an old train rolling down the line. Then I hurry straight home and pack. And if I don't go, I blow my staff. I love you, baby, but you gotta understand, when the Lord made me, he made a rambling man. Some folks might say that I'm no good, that I wouldn't settle down even if I could. But when that open road starts calling to me, there's something over the hill I gotta see. Sometimes it's hard, you gotta understand, when the Lord made me, he made a rambling man. I love to see the towns passing by and ride these rails 'neath God's blue sky. Let me travel this land from the mountains to the sea, 'cause that's the life he meant for me. And when I'm gone and at my grave you stand, just say God called home your rambling man. Just say God called home your rambling man. Give me that old time, old time loving. Give me that old time, old time loving. It was good enough. Mother and father, yeah. That makes me know that it's all right with me, yeah. But what I need is that old time, old time feeling. Gonna get me rocking and reeling. Yeah, yeah. Music will make you move your feet, yeah. I've been trying to love you, babe. The street, yeah. But what I need is that good old time, yeah. I don't want you to turn your back on your friend, no, but I really need that old. I know there are times when I might neglect you, baby, but I want you to come on. I want you to come on. The only thing I want you to do, give me that old time. old time loving. Yeah, yeah. I used to go down there and drink with them. We would drink. I mean, I'd get drunk. And he was, he thought I was a real character, and he wanted me to go to officer training school. He wanted me to go to Yale and then to officer training school. And he decided that he was going to make sure that I did it. And he talked to my parents, and he talked them into taking me to New Haven to meet with some guy, and I guess he was going to pay for it, and I was going to go to Yale. And so the day came, and he came to pick me up. We were going to go to Palomar Airport and take a small plane up to LAX and then fly out to New York. Well, I was at the, I met him at the door, and literally when he got to the door, there was a car that he had hired waiting, and the cops came and cuffed him, arrested him, because he had taken a rubber hose to somebody's dog. He had this little pug dog, and it was Bixby, B-I-X-B-Y. Oh, famous name in Long Beach. There you go. There you go. Oh, yeah. And they arrested him right there on my front porch. Right there on my front door, they arrested him. And he was so pissed off. And he had these tickets, these first-class tickets, and he said, go, you're going. And my parents, I don't know, my parents were, they really didn't know how to handle me. And I said, okay. So I was about 16, and I went and got in this limousine, went to Palomar, and, you know, I flew out to New York. And then I tried to rent a car until they figured out, I didn't even know, can I rent a car? You know, I had a learner's permit. Or I had a license to drive because I was 16. So I tried to rent a car at the airport, and they wouldn't do it. And that's how I found out I couldn't do it, because I couldn't do it. I didn't have a credit card. And I was too young, anyway. So, oh, well, I'm trying to get to New Haven. Well, you can take this jitney, or this little shuttle van bus thing. So I got on that and I went up there. And I went up to I was checked into a hotel right across from the campus. I checked in and I slept overnight. And then I went on campus. I was supposed to meet this guy at like 2 o'clock in the afternoon. I walked around the campus and I looked for the pool. And I swear to God, I went to doorways and sniffed until I smelled chlorine. And then I knew. And I just walked in like I knew what I was doing. I looked like another student, and I found the pool, and it was men only, and no trunks. This was back in the days when men were not afraid of each other's penises. This is back when we had common showers, and no one treated their dick like it was gold. You know, no one thought you were gay if you were naked. You know, it was just another part, just another body part. Like your foot or anything else. Oh man. Anyway, and Yale was a big swimming school, and there was this big name swimmer. What was his name? Don Schollander or something like that. I don't know. And we were the only two people in the pool. Me and this guy. We were the only two swinging dicks in that pool. Schollander, that's right. Schollander. What was his first name? Don Schollander. That's exactly right. That's the guy. He was thin at the hip, broad at the shoulder, blonde hair, toe-headed guy, and we were swimming. And I'd watch him as he passed me. I was looking at his stroke. And he was beautiful. Beautiful swimmer. Beautiful swimmer. He didn't zoom by me. I wasn't slow. But yeah, he was. But I was swimming against, you know, one of the fastest in the world, so I didn't feel too bad about him lapping me. Yeah, if you walk around a locker room now, the way I would, if I walk out of the shower, you know, now you don't have a common shower room. Now everybody's got their own private stall with their own little thing. Nobody look at my wiener. Can I come out now? You know, and everybody's very protective. And they pull their shorts on, like surfers at the beach. You know, they got to keep a towel around themselves and pull their shorts on in the locker room, men. And then if I walk in, it's always some guy my age, you know, because we remember, because we're not that concerned about it. Like, it's a dick, you know. So what? So what, man? Are you a man or not? What is that? It makes me want to see. What do you got there? What is it made of, gold or something? You know, and then if you do walk around like that, you can see a young man going, oh God, this is some old fag. You know, they think I'm, oh God, these fucking kids. Fucking pain in the ass. You know, and so, okay. So now, just to avoid that energy, I cover up. You know, what is wrong? And then don't get me started on the body shaving. You know, so everybody's hiding their penises. Everybody's, you know, shaving their bodies so they look like big babies. Oh yeah, my son in high school on the wrestling team. He said that some kid dropped his towel while they were all changing, and everybody on the team called him gay. Because he made the incredible social faux pas of exposing himself in a men's locker room. So now he was gay, and they tagged him for like a month for that. Man, I've lived too long. I swear to God. By a band called Cake. This is a blunder. I don't wanna worry whether we're gonna stay together till we die. I don't wanna jump in unless the music's thumping. All the dishes rattle in the cupboards when the elephants arrive. I want to love you madly. I want to love you now. I want to love you madly. I want to love you, love you, love you madly. I don't want to fake it, I just want to make it. The ornaments look pretty, but they're pulling down the branches of the tree. I don't want to think about it, I don't want to talk about it. When I kiss your lips, I want to sink down to the bottom of the sea. I want to love you madly. I want to love you now. I want to love you madly. I want to love you, love you madly. I don't slip down. I don't wanna think back to the one thing that I know I should have done. I don't wanna doubt you, know everything about you. I don't wanna sit across the table from you, wishing I could run. I wanna love you madly. I wanna love you now. I wanna love you madly. I wanna love you, love you madly. Love you madly. Love you madly. Me parent, you sont presque tout mort. C'est là qui rêve, il n'a plus en que vous me voir. Quand je malade, il faut que je vais chez les étrangers. Et les souffrances, il faut que je les prends comme ça vient. Aujourd'hui, pas écouter les conseils d'un élan. Aujourd'hui, j'ai tout sauté dans le chemin. Et mes misères feront les pas comme ça vient. Quand je suis malade, il faut que je vais chez les étrangers. Et les souffrances, il faut que je les parle comme ça vient. Pas écouter les conseils d'un élan. Aujourd'hui, j'ai tout sauté dans le chemin. Et mes misères, faudrait je les prends comme ça vient. Et les souffrances, faudrait je les prends comme ça vient.
I'm doing a country song for Fred, everybody. So if you don't like it, talk to Fred. It's called Angel on My Mind. That's why I'm walking.
I've got an angel on my mind. That's why I'm walking. I've got an ache in this old heart now. I ain't talking. The little hand that held mine tight just waved goodbye tonight. I've got her sweet love on my mind. That's why I'm walking. With an old love on your mind, life ain't worth living. I breathe her name with every breath I'm breathing. Why could I never see how much she meant to me? I got her sweet love on my mind. That's why I'm walking. I got an angel on my mind. That's why I'm walking. I've got an ache in this old heart now. Talking. Why could I never see how much she meant to me? I got her sweet love on my mind. That's why I'm walking. I got an angel on my mind. That's why I'm walking. Some are dead and some are living. In my life, I've loved them all. But of all these friends and lovers, there is no one compares with you. And these memories lose their meaning when I think of love as something new. Though I know I'll never lose affection for people and things that went before, I know I'll often stop and think about them. In my life, I love you more. Things that went before, I know I'll often stop and think about them. In my life, I love you more. In my life, I love you more.
I finished this song the other day, and I went, then I went, it's been a long time, now I'm coming back home. F sharp. Because that song came after, this song I just did, on the record, came after. And, it's the same key. So not only do I know what song followed that song, I know what key it was in. And I'm telling you just to demonstrate to you how the Beatles, all the Beatles songs are baked into my bones. Tell me, tell me, Ma, when I go home, the boys won't leave the girls alone. They pulled my hair, stole my comb, but that's all right till I go home. She's handsome, she's pretty, she's the belle of Dublin City. She's a courtin' 1, 2, 3, please won't you tell me who is she? I bet you didn't know this modulated. I feel like singing a little higher. Well, Albert Moon, he says he loves her, all the boys are fighting for. They knock at the door and ring at the bell, saying, oh, my true love, are you well? Out she comes as white as snow, rings on her fingers and bells on her toes. Old Jenny Morrissey says she'll die if doesn't get the fella with the roving eye. She is handsome, she is pretty, she is the belle of Dublin City. She is a courtin' 1, 2, 3, please won't you tell me who is she? Let the wind and the rain and the hail blow high, and the snow comes shoveling from the sky. She's as sweet as apple pie, she'll get her own lad by and by. When she gets a lad of her own, she won't tell her ma when she gets home. Leave them all, and as they will, but it's Albert Mooney that she loves still. She is handsome, she is pretty, she is the belle of Dublin City. She is a courtin' 1, 2, 3, please won't you tell me who is she? She is handsome, she is pretty, she is the belle of Dublin City. She is a courtin' 1, 2, 3, please won't you tell me who is she? I wore my 44 so long, I made my shoulder sore. I wore my 44 so long, I made my shoulder sore. And now I'm wondering, everybody, where'd my baby go? Go. Well, I'm so mad this morning, don't know where in the world to go. Oh, well, I'm looking for some money, pawn my gun for gold. Go. When you see me worried, babe, You know it's you I hate to lose. Every day, 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 I have the blues. When you see me worrying, you know it's you I hate to lose. Okay, here we go. Your hair's all wet, full of sweat. Underskirt ringing wet. You come in here like a goose. Look like somebody tranked you loose. You've been doing something. You've been doing something wrong. You've been doing something. Doing something wrong. I can tell by the way you smell. Grandma and Grandpa out on the porches must be hitting about 90 years. Well, they ain't too old. Great gosh almighty, keep on shifting gears. They ain't too old. They ain't too old. Well, they ain't too old. They ain't too old. I can tell by the way they smell. Come here, mama. Look at little sis, she got her hand in a tootle, up to her wrist. She been doing something, she been doing something wrong. She been doing something wrong. You been doing something, girl. You been doing something wrong. You been doing something. Doing something wrong, I can tell by the way you smell. Ugh. Days have made me older since the last time that I saw your pretty face. A thousand nights had made me colder, and I don't think I can look at this the same. All the miles that separate disappear now when I'm dreaming of your face. I'm here without you, baby.
you're still on my lonely mind. I think about you, baby, and I dream about you all the time. I'm here without you, baby. You're still with me in my dream. And tonight, it's only you and me. Mile just keep on rolling as the people leave the way to say hello. Heard this life is overrated, but I hope that it gets better as we go. Here without you, baby, you're still on my lonely mind. Think about you, baby, and I dream about you all the time. I'm here without you, baby. You're still with me in my dream. And tonight, it's only you and me. Everything I know, anywhere I go, it gets hard, but it won't take away my love. When the last one falls, when it's all said and done, it gets hard, but it won't take away my love. Whoa, whoa, whoa. You're still on my lonely mind. I think about you, baby, and I dream about you all the time. I'm here without you, baby. You're still with me in my dreams. And tonight, it's only you and me.
Do a song of mine now. A happy little ditty about marriage. I know a thing or two about marriage. I know how they start, and I know how they end. I know all I need to know. I don't want to know anymore. Okay? Here's a song I wrote called, well, thank you, Anime. A song I wrote called, I Glaze Over. It goes like this. Honey, don't forget to wash and dry the dishes. Then you have to go to Petco, get the fish's food, and while you're there, pick up a bed for doggy. Since he barfed and peed, now his a stinky soggy. Also get a book of stamps and mail those letters. Plus your mother's birthday is next week, so get her something nice. And when you're home, look in the foyer. There you'll find a FedEx parcel from my lawyer. I don't think you heard me when I said I'm leaving. You're beyond reprieving. Oh, baby, I glaze over as you run down my daily chores. I glaze over, and I'm not sure if you said something more. What was that, my dear? Oh yes, did I mention you can take the baby to the doctor for his flu shot, and then maybe take him to the playground, try to get him tired. By the way, remember that young man we hired? Taught me yoga, transcendental meditation. What you don't know is we had a hot relationship, and you are not the father of our son, and Salvador and I have so much fun. We lie in bed and laugh at your disgusting habits, then we boff like rabbits. Oh, baby, I glaze over when you tell me what I'm gonna do. I glaze over. That's okay, 'cause I'm sure it's nothing new. What was that you said? You don't listen. 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 As you map out my busy day, I glaze over so I don't catch everything you say. Run that by me again. I'm divorcing you because you never listen. 99% of what I say you're missing. I'm so effing sick and tired of you not hearing anything I say. That is why I'm clearing out, so you can kill yourself for all I care. Jump in front of a truck, set fire to your hair. It's not just that you're from Mars and I'm from Venus. Maybe you'll wake up when I cut off your penis. Kick your nuts, make over your face with your sandblaster. Die, you stupid bastard. Oh, baby, I glaze over. But you probably said, I love you. I glaze over, but don't fret, 'cause I love you too. You're my little girl. You don't listen. You don't listen. Okay. We're going to go out on this song. We're going to groove to this song. The late great, he died not too long ago. I was sad to see it. Jerry Reed. And he does this finger picking they call a claw. It's a kind of claw! There was this great Don Adams episode. Don Adams. It was, what was that? Where he was a detective, a police, a cop. That sitcom, Don Adams. It was funny, but I can't remember the name of it. But, you know, you probably couldn't run this now. Because it's too funny. But what it is, the bad guy. The bad guy was this Chinese guy, and he had this big. He was missing a hand, and in his place he had this big prosthetic claw, and that was his name. And well, who shall we say? He goes, tell them it was the Craw, and Don Adams would go, Craw? She goes, no, not Craw, Craw. And it was this recurring thing, through the, get smart. That's right. It was get smart. Maxwell Smart. Boy, see, you guys are smart. David and Denny both got it. Yeah. Craw! Not Craw! What's wrong with you? Okay, this is called claw finger picking style, I guess. And it's Jerry Reed doing a song called Does Anybody Want a Boogie? Thanks, I love you. Thanks for keeping me company. See you next time. going on. We also got two feels going on at the same time.
Guitar sounds real funky, but it feels so good. I bet you can't be still.